Muy buenas tardes. Hello, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Bienvenidos. This is our Bienvenida event for our Latinx Heritage Month. Thank you all so much for being here. My name is Olivia Cortez Figueroa. I am the college recruiter for Cañada College. I get the wonderful honor of being the college recruiter. We have a really fun event for you tonight. Can we go to the next slide, please? Very quickly. We're gonna go over the agenda first, and then we will get started. So first, we are gonna have some comentarios de bienvenida from some of our people here on campus, our administrators, the president of our student association. We're also going to presentarles some nuevos miembros de la familia. And I am unapologetically speaking in Spanglish, y'all, because we all speak Spanglish, right? Most of us anyway. Vamos a presentarles nuevos miembros de la familia de Cañada, some really great folks that we have working with us. We're very lucky to have them. And then we're gonna have a section of folks that have been here for a few years and how we can help you in case you're interested in becoming a Cañada College student. And then we're gonna talk about eventos that are coming up in the next couple of weeks that are also part of our Latinx Heritage event. So, and then at the very end, we're gonna have some preguntas y respuestas, a little bit of time to chat with you all in case you have some preguntas for us. And a quick reminder, this event is going to be recorded. I believe it is already recording. Yes, it is. So once again, thank you all so much for being here. And if we could go to the next slide, please. So first I want to introduce our very own president of the Associated Students of Cañada College. This is the association that is the voice of our students, our wonderful Citlali Curincita. Citlali, I am passing the mic over to you. Thank you for being here and for speaking on behalf of our students.
Hi everyone, hola. My name is Citlali Curincita, and I am the ASCC president for this academic year. My pronouns are she, her, ella, and I am just so excited. All of you are here to build community, and I'm honored to be welcoming you all to this celebratory space. So Latinx Heritage Month, for me, it means honoring where I come from and how my ancestors have paved the way for me to discover who I am today. In doing so today, I honor your ancestors, my ancestors. With that being said, as a proud descendant, we are all the literal definition of our ancestors' wildest dreams. Those are some of my words to you all from the heart, and I'm so excited to be here. I'm so excited to see you all, as I said previously. And thank you. Gracias.
Thank you, Citlali. Gracias for your very beautiful words. And now I would like to present you to, can we go to the next slide, please? So I have the distinguished honor of presenting you to our president of Cañada College, Ms. Kim Lopez. Kim, the mic.
Thank you so much. I so appreciate the introduction, your beautiful words, Citlali. So I'm gonna actually follow what you just said. So as Olivia has said, my name is Kim Lopez and I am serving as the interim president at Cañada College. And I wanna welcome you all to National Latinx Heritage Month. As you know, this is a time for us to recognize the contributions and influence of Latinx Americans to our history, our culture, and achievements of the United States. And I would like to take just a few moments to honor the influence that my own first generation Lopez family had on my life. So if you could show a photo There you go. And I wrote, I had to write this because I knew just seeing my family would get me emotional. So excuse me for reading this. So here in front of us is a photo. My abuelo and my abuela are in the middle. And my abuelo is Julian Castillo Lopez. My abuela is Manuela Trio Lopez. And surrounding them is 10 of their 12 children. My father is sitting and kneeling right next to my grandpa right there. You might be able to see some similarities. He was quite young then. So my great grandpa, my grandparents immigrated to the United States as children in the early 1900s. And my great grandpa and my grandpa and all of my uncles and my father worked for the Phelps Dodge copper mine and smelter in Morenci, Clifton, Arizona. And along with 3,000 other Mexican families, my grandparents lived on Phelps Dodge land, shopped in Phelps Dodge stores, attended Phelps Dodge schools, and were treated at the Phelps Dodge hospitals. Clifton, Arizona was truly a company-owned town. Known as Los Mineros, the Mexican workers were given the most difficult and dangerous jobs for far less pay than their white counterparts, and they were refused entrance into the white-run unions. So in order to secure better wages and a safer work environment and better access to health care, my family joined thousands of other miners and organized the very first Mexican-run union in the copper industry in the United States. So over many decades, Los Mineros battled discrimination and violence and the constant threat of deportation by the Phelps Dodge Company in its attempt to prevent and destroy the union. Yet today, I stand before you as one of thousands of granddaughters, as nieces and daughters of Los Mineros. And I am grateful and indebted to my family, for without their sacrifices and constant fight for what is just, I wouldn't be here today. So I stand on their shoulders, and I hope that all of you that also have Latinx heritage, which I see in the Zoom room is many, many, many of us, that you also spend this month and actually every single day thinking of our ancestors that came here and that have provided so much opportunity for us. It's truly a day of celebration and gratitude for all that we've been given and all the shoulders we have stood on. So thank you for giving me this few moments to talk about my own heritage and the people that I love and that have brought me here today to be with all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, President Lopez. Thank you for sharing a little bit of your story with us. I think a lot of us can relate to those stories. So thank you for sharing that.
Absolutely.
Okay, so now I would like to welcome and introduce our Vice President of Instruction, La Doctora, Doctora Tammy Robinson.
Well, hello, hello, everyone. I am Dr. Tammy Robinson. Bienvenidos. I am so happy to be here. And it's great to share in what college can do for you. And I am so proud to even participate in the Latin Heritage Month, the Latinx Heritage Month celebration. And again, you know, I am come from a family who did not go to college. And I'm a first generation college student. So college for me has a deeply rooted meaning in that when my mother did go back to school when she was almost 30 years old to get her GED, one of the things she stressed to me and my brothers was that we would go to college. So I, as an African-American woman coming through the ranks, I hope that students see someone like myself who didn't see college as a prospect, who didn't see it as something that for me or for my family, I hope that you see Cañada College as the place for you and education as a road that you must travel. So thank you all so much for coming tonight. I hope you get what you can out of this experience. Remember, you get in what you put in, and we are always here to help you. So welcome tonight, and have a wonderful month, a wonderful year. And remember that the administration is always here to help you. So reach out to us if you need us. Thank you all so much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Robinson. I really appreciate your words. And I would like to share that that is one of the wonderful things about Cañada College. Our administration is very supportive, and they genuinely care about our students. We all do. We all care about our students. And that's one of the wonderful things about Cañada College. So thank you for your words. And next, I would like to introduce you to our Vice President of Administrative Services, Ludmila Prisekar. Prisekar, Ludmila, I am so sorry if I messed up your last name.
No worries, no worries. Thank you. I didn't know I have to speak today. So I'm in my car. I apologize for that, but thank you for having me here. I guess I'll just give a little bit of introduction. I'm from Moldova, so my first language is Romanian, so Latin. So I understand Spanish a little bit. And yeah, thank you. Thank you for the welcome. And thank you for inviting me to the event tonight.
Thank you, Ludmila. Next slide, please. And now I have the distinct honor of presenting you to our Vice President of Student Services, Mr. Dr. Manuel Alejandro Perez.
Hola a todos. Good evening. Hello, everyone. My name is Manuel Alejandro Perez. Mis pronombres son él y ellos. I use the he, him, his, and él pronouns. It is such a great honor to be back here again. This is now the second annual Latinx Heritage Month. El segundo año consecutivo que tenemos esta programación para Cañada College, Latinx Heritage Month. We've had events in the past that precede these 2 years of tradition, but I think this is also the first series of programs that we have been able to brand with our particular flavor, our esencia, our colores, our amor for all of the Latinx beauty and testimonios that exist throughout both our United States, Mexico, Centroamérica, the islands, and Sudamérica. We have plenty of diversity and beauty within our spaces. I come to you as a, and I present first, I would like to present first to you as a tío, as a padrino, as an oldest sibling of my siblings and I are all first generation to go to college. We come from a migrant, a campesino background. Mi familia, mis abuelos, mis papás, todos trabajaban en el campo. Y nuestra herencia viene de la tierra, de la madre tierra, de nuestra agricultura, de nuestro movimiento por la tierra, por estos terrenos. And I speak a little bit about migration and movement because I feel like my identities are formed and shaped by movement and migration. And that's one of the reasons why I love being part of this wonderful and beautiful story and testimonio here at the college, because we get to explore as students, as faculty, as staff, and as administrators, what it means to move, to have movement, movement to explore our own identities and how they intersect. I am proudly, orgullosamente Mexicano. I was raised in a Catholic home. I identify as queer and I'm cisgender male. Interrogating all of these identities and how they intersect beautifully and also complicated is something that I've loved to do. And I've had an opportunity to do that, exploring it through higher education. Cañada College is that portal, is an opportunity, is that door, una puerta poder explorar lo que son los diferentes intercambios de nuestras identidades, cómo poder saber lo hermoso, lo bello de nuestro ser y también explorar un poquito lo que es lo complicado de nuestras identidades. Cañada College es un lugar en donde pueden hacer eso. Me da muchísimo gusto estar aquí con todos ustedes y poder participar en este evento de nuevo. Les damos la bienvenida y esperamos que los que estén aquí presentes con nosotros disfruten de nuestra programación y los que también estén viendo este video después de hoy, que estará en nuestra página, que disfruten también de los programas. We hope that you all enjoy our programs that we have set up for Latinx Heritage Month for those of you that are live with us now and those of you that will be watching this on the landing page at a future date. Thank you so much. Olivia, back to you.
Thank you so much, Manuel, for sharing your words. And speaking of movement, you mentioned movement, migration. There is also movement and evolution, right? We're evolving, we're growing, we're changing, we're adapting with this pandemic. Can you talk a little bit about how la pandemia nos ha afectado and what Cañada College, could you share with us what Cañada College is doing to help our students during this time?
Yes, absolutely. Thank you so much, Olivia. It'd be my pleasure. So Cañada College, along with our sister colleges, the College of San Mateo and Skyline College, have really, really tried our best to wrap our arms around our students and make sure that as we are navigating these next few stages of what we are calling recovery, una recuperación con equidad, that we keep equity at the center. To do that, we've done a few things. One of the things that we have done is made sure that as we're exploring how to return to campus, that we are asking our students what they need, that we are asking and looking into our community partners to ask them, how can we support you? What we have learned is that technology is still something that is absolutely a need within our community. So in terms of laptops, access to Wi-Fi, access to hotspots, a strong connection, a space in which to study and connect to your coursework, those are all still necessary resources. The pandemic has had pretty dismal impacts on our communities, and especially in the Latinx community here in the Bay Area, in the Silicon Valley particularly. And so one of the things that we know has been a big help has been our emergency relief fund resources. Whether that has come in the form of direct aid to our students, which has been available and will continue to be available throughout the spring 2022 semester, or if we're talking about helping our students with outstanding debt and making sure that debt becomes less and less of a barrier to continued education. One of the most important pieces I would say is that our Board of Trustees have recently made a decision to support the health and wellness of our district, and in doing so, mandating that to continue taking in-person courses in the spring 2022 semester, all of our community will need to be vaccinated. This is particularly important for students. It also applies to our faculty, staff, and administration. We do this together. I'll say it again, we do this together. In order to continue taking courses in person for the spring 2022 semester, all of our students will need to have either their proof of vaccination or have gone through a process to determine if they can be exempted from a vaccination based on medical or religious purposes or reasons. All of that information is available to you, our students, in a variety of ways. By email. At this point, you should have received one email that was distributed last Friday. You will receive another one that will be coming out very, very soon, within the next week. Actually, even less than that, now that we're at Monday, within a few days. You'll also have that information available to you on the landing pages. But as is evidenced from our recent reach outs by our broadcast media, Univision was asking us to provide Spanish broadcast information regarding our emergency relief efforts. I will leave with just translating one important piece, which is para nuestros alumnos, es importantísimo tener en cuenta que seguimos apoyando con servicio y apoyo directo, asistencia financiera para nuestros alumnos que siguen tomando cursos con nosotros y aún tienen esperanzas de registrarse para la primavera. Lo principal que tienen que tener en mente, que si ustedes como alumnos piensan tomar cursos en la primavera, por favor, tengan en cuenta que necesitan subir la información de sus vacunas contra el COVID-19. Si no tienen esa prueba, también pueden pasar por un proceso para justificar que no van a tener la vacuna por cuestiones de salud médica o por cuestiones religiosas. De ambas formas, se necesita subir la información lo más pronto posible para evitar alguna interrupción en poder tomar cursos en persona para la primavera del 2022. De nuevo, por favor, tengan en mente que necesitan subir toda la información sobre su vacuna contra el COVID-19 antes de registrarse para evitar una interrupción en tomar cursos en persona para la primavera. There's many opportunities for us to continue providing this support for our students and our families. Cañada College and the San Mateo County Community College District is here to support each and every one of our familias. And so I'll stick around, of course, Olivia, and if there's any further information that we can provide, we are happy to do so. We are here for our comunidad. Gracias.
Thank you, Dr. Perez, for sharing that information. Very important for all of us to know and all of our students to know. Next slide, please. Okay, we are going to introduce some new Cañada College colegas. We are very lucky to have them on staff. And I'm going to introduce one by one. Do we have Claudia Alvarado here tonight? Okay. I don't think we have Claudia. So let's jump over to the next person, Marcos Chacon Jr. We have a new personal counselor. Marcos, are you here? I do believe I saw you.
Good afternoon. Yes, I'm here.
Thank you, Marcos. The mic is yours.
Muchas gracias. Buenas noches. My name is Marcos. I am also the new personal counseling coordinator and personal counselor. And my pronouns are he, him, él. And it's a privilege to join just the staff here at Cañada and to be part of the Personal Counseling Center. And, you know, one of the reasons I came to Cañada and sought just working on campus was because even in my own journey, one of the first times I started to go to counseling was actually in a college. I remember going to SF State, and it was like the first time I've ever sought out services. And it was one of the most pivotal and important moments in my life where it just led to it led to other decisions that I made, and it helped me so much during a pivotal time in my life. And so that's the same experience we want to serve you here at the Personal Counseling Center. You know, being first generation college students, you know, we go through some experiences that sometimes are very difficult. Sometimes we're caregivers. Sometimes we have a lot of stress. It's like a journey of itself of just going through and being the breakthrough person in our families to seek out education, maybe for the first time. And so sometimes it's just beneficial to actually go and talk to somebody and process a lot of those things. And that's a space that we want to give you at the Personal Counseling Center. And especially right now in all this time with COVID and just everything going on this year, we also want to be a resource as we all have been impacted in our mental health, in our stress response, in just a lot of grief that maybe we have experienced, a lot of the decisions that we have had to make. It's a very stressful time. And so we also want to be a resource for you if you're facing any challenges with your mental health, with your emotions, with your overall well-being. So again, thank you for having me today. And then if I can be of service, sin pena, como dicen, sin vergüenza, please reach out. And I want to be a resource for you and your well-being. Take care.
Gracias, Marcos. Thank you for those words. It is very nice to have somebody who understands what it's like to be Latinx. And like you said, some of you know, some of our students are caregivers, and, you know, a lot of us on staff were in the same boat. So it's good to have you on board here at Cañada College. Our next person that I'd like to introduce to you is our Interim Director of Financial Aid, Andrea Garcia Ridgers. Andrea, are you around?
I believe I am. Hello, everybody. I'm Andrea Garcia Ridgers. I am the Interim Financial Aid Director here at Cañada, and I'm so happy to be here. Like most of you, I am a first generation college student. I was very scared to start college. I wasn't sure what I was going to do. I didn't know where to go. Even stepping foot on campus was something that was very scary because nobody in my family ever did it. Lucky for me, I joined all the programs that I could possibly do. I reached out for help. I had that self-advocacy skills to really go and find out what resources I can utilize. And I was able to attend something like this where I got to meet all the people on campus who really care and matter. And they just kind of were my cheerleaders and said, keep going, get your AA, keep going, get your bachelor's, keep going, get your master's. And I just kept going and kind of just working my way up. One of the things I'm very passionate about is financial aid, because if it wasn't for financial aid, I would have not been able to achieve any of my goals. So I want everyone to be able to apply for financial aid, get the resources, the help that you need. We understand it's a complex process. That's why we're here to help. Anything you need, any place that you get stuck, whether it's financial aid or anything else, anything that you need, let us know. That's one of the biggest takeaways, is we don't know what you need until you tell us. So let us know what you need. And we are here to help, especially in the financial aid department. We are open all week long, Monday through Friday. Come see us, even if it's just to say hi. I look forward to meeting you.
Thank you so much, Andrea. That means a lot. When I'm out there doing outreach and meeting prospect students, one of the very first questions that I get is, what about financial aid? So it means a lot that we have a financial aid team that is so supportive. Thank you. All right, the next person I'd like to introduce you to is Nayeli Gonzalez. She is the new Welcome Center Office Assistant. Nayeli.
Gracias, Olivia. Buenas noches, everyone. My name is Nayeli Gonzalez, and I am at the Welcome Center. My pronouns are she, her, and ella. I joined the Welcome Center at Cañada. I was attracted because, like everybody else, I am also first generation college. And so I remember learning how to navigate through, I attended Skyline myself. So learning how to navigate through college. And I feel like the work at the Welcome Center is amazing. We are here to help with scheduling counseling appointments, to helping you learn how to register for your classes, pretty much a one-stop shop for resources. So I am looking forward to meeting you all. Please come by the Welcome Center if you have any sort of questions, and we'll be more than happy to help.
Gracias, Nayeli. Nayeli is the go-to person. You want to connect with Nayeli because she is at the front of it all, the Welcome Center. She can help you schedule those counseling appointments, you know, if you just need a little bit of extra help. So gracias, Nayeli.
Thank you, Olivia.
The next person I'd like to introduce you is Christy Longoria, and she is our newest Spark Point coordinator. Christy?
Hi, everyone. Yes, my name is Christy Longoria. I am the newest member of the Spark Point team. Just started over the summer, but I'm really excited to be here. I have a true passion for working with our community college students. I am a product of my local community college and also a graduate in STEM. And I don't think I would have made it through my four-year program if it were not for all of the support programs that exist at the community colleges. So I'm really excited to be part of SparkPoint, and we help focus on helping our students reach their financial goals, defining what their financial goals are, really just talking about money and how sometimes that can be a barrier. As Andrea had mentioned, you know, financial aid is really important. I unfortunately was one of those people that had to turn down my first choice college to UCLA after I was accepted because I couldn't afford to go. I was a math major, intended to be a math major at UCLA, but I knew I was going to come out with about $55,000 worth of debt because I did not fill out my financial aid applications correctly. And so one of my passions really then became, how do we help our students? How do we make sure that they don't fall into, you know, sort of what seems like the day-to-day struggle to get to where you want to go, that you kind of forget about some of that long-term planning and the importance of really utilizing your resources and tools that exist. So for those students that are listening, staff that are listening, if you have questions about financial anything, feel free to stop by and say hi to us at SparkPoint. We're available both online and on site throughout the week too. So it's really great to be here. Thanks for the invitation.
Thank you, Christy. Thank you for sharing all of that information. Next, I would like to introduce you to Jose Manso. He is our newest EOPS counselor. Jose.
Buenas noches. Jose Manso, he, him, él. Pronouns, a new EOPS counselor here at Cañada College. Honestly, I'm so happy to plant my roots here, you know, at Cañada, be a part of this new tradition or this continuing tradition going forward. Looking back at my time as a student, I wouldn't be here in the first place if it wasn't for my counselors along the way. That's why I became a counselor. My high school counselor would take me out of class, make me apply for financial aid to apply to colleges, would just really do the most above and beyond just to get me on the right path because they saw potential in me. So for me, I think it's always about giving back to the community, to the next generation of Latinx folk and also students in general going forward and, you know, just giving back. I think I really believe in that. I believe in the mission of like programs like TRIO, EOPS, EOP, Puente, all these programs, if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't even be where I'm at as well, being a part of those programs as a student, and also giving back now as an EOPS counselor. So looking forward to continuing the work. I know it's just begun, and I'm super happy to be here.
Gracias, Jose. Yes, if you do not know what EOPS is, you need to get in touch with the EOPS office. If you don't know what any of these programs are, reach out to any one of us. We will help you. We will share information with you. We have so many programs on campus that, yes, just reach out to any one of us. We have lots of great programs for our students. Next, I'm going to jump over Griselda. For a sec, oh, do we have a video? Okay, I believe I'm being asked to jump over Griselda, so we're gonna come back to Griselda. I would like to introduce you to Janet Rios. She is our new Dream Center coordinator. Janet?
Hi, everyone. It's nice to meet y'all. Thank you for inviting me. I'm super happy to be here today and just excited to learn who everyone is. I think, you know, I'm still learning faces, and so I appreciate it every time. Like Olivia said, I am currently the new Dream Center coordinator at Cañada College. I'm super happy to be a part of your story, a part of your journey, and learning as I go, learning needs of the students, you know, the work that's been done already, and what, you know, what is needed, what is pending to be done. And so I'm also first generation Latina, born and raised in the Central Coast of a small town called Santa Maria. And so I'm the oldest of three. And like many of you, you know, my parents came to this country seeking an opportunity. And I'm the first in my family to go to college. And so I think that's what kind of inspired me to get involved in school. Like I just had all this energy to explore what college was, and a mentor was like, you should go into student affairs, you know, your resume that you have, you know, you're super involved. And I had no idea what that was. I just knew I liked the college environment. And like many of you, I struggled with the financial aid application. I think I submitted it 5 times in high school, senior year, in the library before I finally got it right. And oftentimes you have complicated family situations. And when it's your first time filling it out, I think you feel like it has to be right or else the federal government's gonna like come after you, you know? But they don't. It's just more like they just want to know the estimates. And so I really appreciate April Montez. I say that name because if it wasn't for her, I would have never figured it out. She really paved that for me, that path. And I try and channel all the people who helped me when I help other students, channel what I wish I had. And also, you know, undocumented students, I'm an ally. I want to be a part of the conversation and support them. And that's why I'm in this work. You know, personal lived experience. I'm privileged to have been born here, but family members are directly impacted by this. And so that is why I do this work. And so I'm excited to be here. And I'll put my email in the chat, whatever you all need. I'm on Zoom at the moment, but I am an email away, and a lot of folks know how to get a hold of me. So definitely reach out. I'm here.
Thank you, Janet. And now we are going to share. So Griselda Paredes unfortunately couldn't be here tonight, but she did record a little video to share with us tonight.
Saludos, mi nombre es Griselda Paredes. I use she, her, ella pronouns, and I am the interim student life and leadership manager at Cañada College. I work with the most amazing people at the Center for Student Life and Leadership Development. In addition to providing leadership to all 16 services that our center provides, I advise the associated students of Cañada College. Our student senate represents the voice of the entire campus through participatory governance. Yo te puedo ayudar a desarrollar tu liderazgo. I can help you develop into your leadership. Clubs are one of the many aspects that make Cañada College so great. Clubs are still active and our inter-club council is still meeting. Cañada College clubs and organizations focus on student interest in careers, multicultural diversity, recreation, politics, the environment, and more. They're a great way to get involved, build friendships, and they're a really great resume builder. Yo te puedo ayudar a empezar un nuevo club. I can help you start a new club. Yo te puedo ayudar a divertirte en Cañada College. I can help you have fun at Cañada College. Each year, Student Senate hosts various events that provide fun and engaging opportunities for students. Furthermore, the Center for Student Life and Leadership Development can help you get your student body card and can also meet with you to help find housing assistance. Nosotros te podemos ayudar a obtener tu credencial estudiantil y opciones de vivienda. I'd like to invite you to visit us on campus. We're located in Building 5, Room 354. We can't wait to meet you and ayudarte.
Now an overview. I can help you develop your leadership by joining ASCC. I could help you get involved with student clubs. Te puedo ayudar by telling you about events on campus. And we can help you obtain a student body card and talk to you about housing assistance. Check us out online at cañadacollege.edu/studentlife.
Wow, what a great video, Griselda. Put together. That was very informative. Thank you, Griselda. Next slide, please. And now we're going to talk to a couple of people that are not new to our campus, but we can also ayudarte in different ways. We have different people on campus that we are ready, willing, and able to help in your journey to becoming a Cañada College student. I'm going to go ahead and start with myself. My name is Olivia Cortez Figueroa, and I'm the college recruiter. Yo te puedo ayudar a aplicar a Cañada College with the application process to become a Cañada College student. There are a couple of steps. The very first one is submitting your Cañada College application, but there are a couple of other onboarding steps that I can help you with all the way through registration. It's a simple process, but you know, sometimes we don't know what we don't know, and that's what I'm here for. I have a team of campus ambassadors who are also students, and they can help you with the process as well when I'm not available. That is our job, and we love helping you. We love answering students. Or maybe if we can't help you, we help you connect with somebody else on campus who can help you. So I absolutely love my job here because I get to share information about the wonderful programs that we have here at Cañada College. So that is how outreach can ayudarte. And now I'd like to introduce Nimzy Garcia, and she is from Eso Adelante, and she is also going to share cómo ella te puede ayudar también.
Thank you, Olivia. So, buenas tardes. Hi, everyone. My name is Nimzy Garcia. I use the pronouns she, her, ella, and I am the program services coordinator for our Eso Adelante program here at Cañada College. So Eso Adelante is a grant-funded program that comes from Cañada's Hispanic Serving Institution designation. So in our program, we serve students who identify as Hispanic or Latinx, first-generation and low-income in their transfer pathway to San Francisco State University. So we have a variety of transfer supports that we offer students that include workshops, SF State visits, connections to SF State staff and faculty and folks who can help you get connected and transfer successfully. And we also have peer mentors, all of whom are current Cañada students. They're academically successful, they're really cool, and they're motivated to support their peers to achieve their academic goals. So we have a really quick application that you can fill out. You can choose to either one, work with a peer mentor or just access our general services. So I'm gonna drop our brochure in the chat shortly. And I'll also share a little bit about myself. So I also navigated Cañada as a student, as a first generation student. And I know that being connected to resources was instrumental in helping me transfer. So personally, I love the work that I do. I love that we are transfer focused and that we primarily serve Latinx, first generation and low income students, because I identified as all of those. And had I not been in EOPS, had I not had the support of faculty and other folks at the college, I don't think I would have ever felt confident enough in myself to transfer. So that is a little bit about the kind of support that we offer and how deeply passionate we are to help our students.
Thank you, Nimzy, for sharing about Eso Adelante. I will tell you, I went directly to a four-year university, but that's only because I didn't know about community colleges. And let me tell you, if I could go back, I would probably go through a community college for my first couple of years. So thank you for sharing that. Next, I'd like to introduce you to Maria Junin, and she is from Trio SSS. Maria?
Hi, thank you so much for having me. I am just going to speak very briefly because I see that we're running short on time. I wanted to say a little bit about our TRIO programs. Like many of us here tonight, I was able to move forward through my college experience by the support of a program that really motivated me and got me through this. And I was part of the TRIO Upward Bound program at Mills College. And so when I was able to finally give back to my own community, because I'm from the peninsula, I was able to come back and work here at Cañada since 2004 in the TRIO programs. So we have a pipeline program that goes from high school with the Upward Bound program through the college system here at Cañada called TRIO SSS. And there you can get support with finding the right pathway for you, with finishing your academics and your goals on time, and also transferring. And then we help you catch up while you're in the transfer process and as you continue and complete your degree. We wanna make sure that you're part of a community. And so therefore a lot of what we do is provide you resources, listen to you, and also support you. Like other programs on this campus, we have TRIO ambassadors or students who are able to relate with you and listen to you and give you a good set of directions and advice without making it seem like, oh, you need to do one thing or another, but just a good listening ear. So I hope that you'll consider applying to our TRIO programs. Let's see, I'll put a flyer in as well, just like Nimzi just did. So thank you.
Thank you, Maria. And now we're going to jump over to Ariela Villalpando from the Promise Scholars Program. Ariela?
Thank you, Olivia. Hello, everyone. My name is Ariela Villalpando. My pronouns are she, her, ella. And thanks for having me tonight. Yo te puedo ayudar by helping you apply to the Promise Scholars Program. Although we have closed our applications for the fall, we are still open for spring cohorts. And once we hit next year, which is right around the corner, our application will open around February for our fall 2022 cohort. To share a little bit about Promise, we offer comprehensive support and we offer 2 to 3 years of tuition coverage. We pay for your books. We have dedicated counselors and we just have a multitude of services to help our students complete their degree between 2 to 3 years, whether your goal is to receive a certificate, to receive a degree or transfer, we are here to support you. So please check us out. I'll add my email shortly and also our website to learn about more details about our program as well as the application itself. Thank you, Olivia.
Thank you, Ariela. Very, very important information about our Promise Scholars Program. Gracias. And now we're going to jump back to Janet Ramirez from Excel. She was not able to be here tonight, but she did send us a video to share with us.
Hello, everyone. Hola a todos. My name is Janet Ramirez Hernandez. My pronouns are she, her, hers, and ella. And I'm the transition coordinator at Cañada College for Excel, which stands for Adult Education, College and Career Educational Leadership. My role at the college is to help students transition from our local adult schools to Cañada College, and I mainly serve students transitioning from Sequoia Adult School, San Mateo Adult School, La Costa Adult School, South San Francisco Adult School, and Jefferson Adult School, which is located in Daly City. My main focus is to support students transitioning from the adult schools to our campus, whether the goal is to attain a certificate, degree, transfer, attaining skills, or whatever the goal might be. I support students from the very beginning, helping them fill out the college application, financial aid, technology, connecting them with resources, all the way down to making sure that they have the correct books and are ready for the first day of class. I also work closely with our ESL department. So every semester we offer our level one ESL course, which is our ESL 921 grammar and writing class at Sequoia Adult School. So we offer this class at their campus, both in the evening and the morning. And this has been such a successful class in having many students transition from the adult school to Cañada College. This has helped make the transition from the adult school to college more comfortable and less intimidating for many students. Our college counselors and our support services also make a visit down to the adult school to welcome them and connect them with resources. We also host our college and ID event every year where students get the opportunity to come up to Cañada to explore the campus, learn about different programs at the college, take their picture and get their college ID. So this is a really fun and informational event that helps ease the transition just a bit as well. So that's just a little bit about Excel. Please feel free to connect with me if you have any questions or would like to get more information about any of the services or how I can support. I hope to meet many of you soon. Bye.
Thank you, Janet, for that very informational video. Janet is definitely my go-to person when I have prospect students coming in who might need to take a couple more classes at the adult school before they transition into Cañada College. So if that sounds like something that you might need, reach out to me or reach out to Janet. She is super helpful. All right, now we are going to jump in to talk about some of the events that are coming up for Latinx Heritage Month. We're going to make this super quick and then we're going to open it up for any questions that anyone may have. So let's talk about our very next event, which is Martes Gigante. Is that you, Nimzi? Yes, take it away, Nimzi.
That's me. All right, so tomorrow afternoon, we are going to be hosting, Griselda and I are going to host Martes Gigante, which is inspired by Sábado Gigante, a variety TV show that ran on TV for a pretty long time. So we're gonna play a couple of games. We're gonna have some competition. If you like having fun, if you like having a good time, feel free to join us. The link is here on the slides, but if someone can help me out and send it in the chat, one of the games that we're gonna be playing is gonna be a quiz, and it is gonna be about Sábado Gigante. So if you feel like you know your show, if you feel like you know your Latinx pop culture, feel free to join us and show us.
Thank you, Nimzy. That sounds like so much fun. Who remembers Sábado Gigante? I know I do. Yep, I see a few of you. All right, the next event we're going to tell you about is our, let's talk about mental health. Ariela?
Thank you. Just waiting for the slide to kick in. Yes, thank you, Olivia. Through a promised collaboration with the Personal Counseling Center, we are gonna have an open conversation and dialogue with our new personal counselor, Marcos Chacon, who just introduced himself earlier. And we're gonna just talk about mental health and how we could recognize and normalize the conversations around mental health and how we could start that conversation with our families and with our friends, and also learning ways to take care of ourselves and making sure we're healthy and our minds are okay and our spirits are being nourished and we're taking care of ourselves by learning from the professionals on campus. So please join us. It will be from 2 to 3:30 on Wednesday, October 6th in the next upcoming week. So I'm excited and I hope to see you all there.
Thank you, Ariela. Very important topic, yes. And now we're going to tell you about another workshop that we are having, Testimonios of our Latinx Transfer Students. Nimzy?
Okay, so this is going to be an event that we hosted last year and we wanted to bring back this year because it was so popular and super valuable. So in a collaboration between Eso Adelante, the STEM Center, and the Promise Scholars Program, we are going to bring a couple of our Latinx transfer alumni to talk about their experience, share their testimonials, the resources that helped them both here at Cañada and in their transfer institution to be successful. So if you wanna meet some of our alumni, hear their stories, we strongly encourage you to attend. It'll be another really fun event. Join us to celebrate our students and to learn from their experiences and their wisdom.
Thank you, Nimzy. You all do not want to miss that one. It's going to be a good one. Okay, so now we have come to the end of tonight's workshop. Does anybody have any preguntas for us, for anybody here? You can put it in the chat. You can unmute yourself. We are all familia here. Going once. Going twice. I see a comment. No questions, but that for a great intro and lineup of events. Thank you so much. Okay, in that case, we do have a question. Maria?
Hi, Olivia. I'm so sorry. I wanted to take this opportunity. First of all, thank you for inviting all of us to attend. Thank you for the reminder because I had completely forgot. It was like, oh, wait, I was going to get ready to leave. And I thought, no, let me just stay. I'm glad I have my laptop. I wanted to welcome everybody, especially all the new staff to Cañada College. My name is Maria Lara Blanco, and I'm the interim registrar at Cañada. Please feel free to reach out to me with any questions you may have. I'm also a first generation. I also attended Cañada College. I love it here. I'm actually starting, I think, I think, my 34th year here at Cañada College. So this truly is a family place. My family also migrated back in the 60s. So also, like I said, first generation. For everybody, I love hearing your stories, and I'm so happy that we're all here to help all of our students. Any questions you may have regarding admissions, you know, registration, just please feel free to reach out to me. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Maria, for being here and for introducing yourself and sharing a little bit about you. Thank you for all of your help all the time.
You're welcome.
I know I'm always bugging you.
No, it's never bugging. We're here for each other.
Thank you, Maria. All right, anybody else have any questions, comments? Okay, then if we can go to the very last slide. I want to give a super big thank you, a super big gracias to the Latinx Heritage Month planning team. All of these folks that you see, whose names you see up here, put a lot of work into all of these events. So thank you for being here. If you weren't here to see it live, thank you for popping in and seeing the recording. Please join us for the other events. Hopefully you can make that one live. And if you can't see the recording too, gracias, Gonzalo, Margarita, Citlali, Jose, Nimzi, Griselda, Dr. Perez, Megan, Nadia, Ariela, and Jose. Thank you so much. This could not happen without you all. So thank you for being here, and we'll see you at the next event. Bye, everybody.
Bye. Great music, Olivia.
I can't take the credit for that. That is all Nimzi. She's our DJ. Thank you, Nimzi. Got us dancing.